In this video, I will explain what is client and server, that is client server configurations. Here we go, client and server terminology definition. Before we discuss various client server configurations in the context of SAP systems, we first need to define the concepts client and server. There are basically two ways of doing this. We'll see what are all these ways. In the hardware oriented view, the term server means the central server in a network that provides data, memory and resources for the workstation clients. In the software oriented view, client and server are both defined at the process level service. A service in this context is a service provided by a software component. The software component can consist of a process or a group of processes such as SAP web application server and is then called a server for that service. Software components that use a service are called clients. At the same time, clients can also be servers for other specific services. Following graphic clarifies the two approaches to the definitions. Just let us look at the graphic. This is a hardware oriented view. Here the server is there and here it is the client. So client and server, this is one physical computer, this is another physical computer. Server holds some resources and client will receive the resources from the server through either LAN or WAN. This is the concept of client server configurations in hardware oriented view. If it is a software oriented view, so you can have an application in the single computer. So that is a process, one server process, and the same computer another process called client process. Client process request of a service, server process provision of a service. That means server will provide the information what the client is requested. So this is explanation of client server configuration in software oriented view. Okay. Now, coming to the SAP systems, in the context of SAP systems, the terms client and server are generally used as defined in the software oriented view. In the SAP systems, client and server are generally used as defined in the software oriented view because single computer can be used for installing server process as well as client process. Let us look at this client server configuration for SAP systems. The following processes are often used for operating business application software. Following processes. What are all the processes? One is presentation processes and application processes, database processes. In the presentation processes, for example, for displaying screen, whatever the screens we are looking at, like SAP GUI screens, that is presentation process. And application processes, all executing whatever the operations we do, that execution will be done at the application process level. And database processes, for example, for maintaining and organizing database data, whatever the data is maintaining will be at database processes. So that all the processes divided into different layers, that is presentation processes, application processes, database processes. When you are installing and configuring an SAP system, you need to decide how you are going to distribute the required processes among the available hardware. There are various ways of doing this, some of which are described in more detail below. Configurations are either single tier or multi-tier depending on the number of hardware layers used. See the following graphic. The SAP ECC system is an example of business application software. In single tier configuration, all processing tasks, database, application and presentation processes are performed by one computer. This is classic mainframe processing. Two-tier configurations are usually implemented using special presentation servers that are responsible solely for formatting the graphical interface. In a three-tier configuration, each layer runs on its own host. Many different application servers can simultaneously work with the data of a database server. See this graphic. Here, in two-tier configuration, presentation processes are running at presentation layer, that means front-end computers. So SAP GUI software will be installed in the front-end computer, and but the application and database processes will be installed in the single computer, that is server, single server. Single server will be used for installing application processes and database processes. It is called two-tier configuration. If it is a single-tier configuration, same SAP GUI, if you can install on this server itself, it is called single-tier configuration. That is presentation, application, database processes. All the processes are installing in single server. That means it is called single-tier configurations. Okay, that means client, server, processes are all included in the single server. That is single-tier configurations. If it is two-tier configuration, presentation layer is separated from the application and database layer. Application database layer are installed, or application or database layers are maintained at single server. And three-tier configuration, you see, the database is separated from the application server. So these three are application servers. Here we have application servers. Out of these application server, one is central instance and second one is dialog instance, third one is also dialog instance. Central instance, dialog instance, dialog instance. In this way you can install any number of dialog instances here in the at the application layer, but the database server is single database server. It is the concept of three-tier configuration. That is, front-end computers will have SAP GUI software, so that SAP GUI, through SAP GUI, user will log on to the SAP system. That request will goes to the application server, and application server will process the information, that is execute the applications, and if it is required, the data is required from the database, it will contact the database server and it will give the response to the user machine by the application server. So this is concept of three-tier configuration. And multi-tier, another layer called web browser, that is from browser also you can access SAP systems, that is here Internet Explorer. So that's why it is called multi-tier configurations. It is extra presentation layer, that's it. Application layer is same here and database layer is same as three-tier configurations. Only extra layer here is internet. Through internet also you can access SAP systems. Another way of getting screens from the application server to the users. So this is about simple client server configurations in the SAP system. Here detailedly explained about this same concept. Here we'll read once quickly. Single tier configurations are generally used for tests and demonstrations. For example, an SAP system on a laptop. For suppose if you are planning to learn SAP system, SAP software like SAP Business Administrator, you can install all processes in the single system. Single tier configurations are generally used for tests. So you can test that particular application. And demonstration, if you want to demonstrate, like for suppose I am using the system to demonstrate to you people. Okay, I will use single tier configurations. For example, an SAP system on a laptop, I can install SAP software in the laptop so that I can explain what is SAP system and how to install it and how to work with it. So single laptop is enough for explanation purpose. Okay, for me, if I install single tier configuration, it is okay. If many users want to work on a system, for suppose more than two people, more than one people wants to work in the single system, okay, in the single system, if they want to work, so we will keep one server and two front-end computers, or one server is for one person and another client computer for another person. Two people will work simultaneously on the single SAP system. Okay, for suppose you and me, I have a server with SAP application server, database server and SAP presentation layer all installed in the single system. I will work on my server. But if you want to work along with me, you can install SAP GUI program on your computer, and from your SAP GUI program you can connect, log on to SAP system, SAP server which is installed on my server. So within the same system you and me can work together. So if many users want to work on a system configured in this way, then the extra hardware cost for each additional user become greater than the cost associated with implementing additional hardware levels. For example, moving the presentation processes to other host. So only presentation processes will be moved to another host. Single system, single server computer, and remaining are presentation front end computers. And in the two tier configuration with the distributed presentation processes, as shown in the previous graphic, can maintain good performance of a significantly higher number of users without substantially increasing the hardware cost. The load resulting from the presentation process is distributed to the various front end computers, and so does not influence the performance of the database host. Okay, two tier configurations, all presentation level is distributed to different front end computers. And however, if the number of users exceeds a certain upper limit, the central host on which both application and database processes run risks becoming a bottleneck. To prevent this, you can improve the performance of the SAP system by distributing the application layer processes to several hosts. So here it is distributed to several hosts at application level. Okay, like this. Another advantage of adding a hardware layer significantly, specifically for application processes, is that it facilitates scalability, so that you can increase the capacity of the SAP system by adding number of application servers. Like central instance, if you have Dialog instance, can be installed in another physical server. Database server is same, but application servers can be increased at your own requirement. If the number of SAP users in a SAP system increases over time, negatively affecting system performance, then this problem can in most cases be solved simply by adding another host for application processes. For application processes, you can add another host. An alternative two-tier configuration is to install powerful desktop systems and to use these for presentation applications, two-tier client server. These configurations are especially suited to applications with high processor demands, for example simultaneous simulations are for software developers but are not implemented in the SAP environment other than for test purposes due to the additional administration required. Like some people wants to like developers wants to have application server installed on their laptop or high-end desktop computers. Instead of accessing remote application server, they will have application processes on their laptop or desktop computer, and database will be located at some other location. Okay, this type of scenario also possible. Okay, that is the meaning of this paragraph. And now, in the SAP Business Suite environment, more complex client-server configurations consisting of more than three tiers are both theoretically possible and used in practice. An additional level could be a web server, for example. Like, you can access SAP systems using Internet Explorer and Mozilla Firefox. Right now, Chrome is not supported for accessing SAP systems. That is called accessing systems through Internet is called SAP GUI for HTML. Okay. I hope you understood very well about client-server configurations, like client-server concept at software-oriented view and hardware-oriented view. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Just go through this particular section for thorough understanding.